Hello everyone, this is Shanti Shirsat from Information Technology Department. In this session, we learn about the reference model for computer network. Learning outcomes. Introduction of OSI reference model. OSI reference model, its layers and their functions. Introduction. Open System Interconnection, that is OSI model, is a reference model for developed by ISO, that is International Organization for Standardization, in 1984. It is a group of function and set of rules called protocols, which are necessary to establish and conduct the communication between two or more computers or parties. The model consists of total 7 layers, and each layer performs some function related to that particular operation. OSI reference model is a logical framework for standards for the network communication protocols, which are based on standard OSI model. OSI defines the standard by which computer can communicate with each other. It is a simple set of protocols which governs the various aspects of networking. It is the network data communication, and it is defined into the 7 layers. Each layer of OSI model provides the services for the next higher layer. Each layer communicates logically with its associated layer on the other computer. In OSI model, the packets are sent from one layer to another layer in order of layer from top to bottom on the sending computer, and then in reverse order on the receiving computer. Each layer of OSI model performs unique, generic, and well-defined function. This is a layered architecture of OSI model, that is protocol hierarchy, having 7 layers: application, presentation, session, transport, network layer, data link layer, and physical layer. Upper 3 layers are related to the software, that's why it's called the software layers. Transport layer is the heart of OSI, and network layer, data link layer, and physical layer, which are related to hardware resources used at the time of data communication or for the data transmission. That's why these are the hardware layers. This is the layered architecture of the OSI model. At the first 3 layers, that is topmost layer, the data is called, or information is called, data. At the transport layer, this data, the large data, is divided into the segments, that is small part. Then these segments at the network layer contains the packet, because here the network layer or router adds the IP address in each packet. After that, at the data layer, it adds the hardware address of the device, that is MAC address of the device. So here it's called the frames. And after that, this data at the physical layer is converted into the bits, that is 0 and 1 form, and through the transmission media it transmitted from sender to receiver. At receiver at the sender side perform the encapsulation at every level, and decapsulation is performed at the receiver side, and finally data is transmitted or displayed at the device, that is receiver device. Each layer of the OSI model, that is sender side, all the layers communicate with each other, but every adjacent layer, means sender's application layer, communicate with application layer of the receiver using peer-to-peer protocol. Same like all the layers at the sender side communicate with respective layer at the receiver side. The first layer in the OSI reference model, that is physical layer. It is the lowest layer of OSI model. Physical layer deals with the mechanical and electrical specification of the interference and transmission media, means which type of transmission media we use, its characteristics and its specifications are specified in the physical layer. The functions of the physical layer: one is a data encoding, that is, Physical layer modifies the simple layer signal patterns, that is 0s and 1, used by the PC to the better accommodate the characteristics of the physical medium. Means at the physical layer, data is in the form of 0s and 1, and this physical layer converts the data into the appropriate format, which is depend on which type of transmission media we use, that is twisted pair cable, coaxial cable or fiber optic cable. Depend on that, it converts that data into the particular format. LAN configuration defines the way how two or more devices can be connected physically. Next function is data transmission. It defines the transmission mode, whether it is simplex, half duplex or full duplex between two devices. Signals, it determines the type of signal used for transmitting the information. Bit synchronization, the physical layer provides the synchronization of bits by providing the clock. This clock controls both the sender and receiver, thus providing synchronization at bit level. Physical topologies, the physical layer specifies the way in which the different devices or nodes are arranged in the network, that is bus, star or mesh topology. Next layer is data link layer. At this layer, data frames from the network layer to physical layer. Means data layer sends the data frames from network layer to physical layer. Transmission of data encapsulation is called frames. There are two types of sublayers present at this data link layer. One is logical link control and another one is medium access control. Logical link is responsible for transmitting the packets to the network layer of the receiver, that is receiving. And the media access control layer is a link between the logical link control layer and the network's physical layer. It is used for transmitting the packets over the network. Next, function of the data link layer. First is link establishment and termination, then providing the physical address, that is MAC address, then creates the frame of data, then gives the frame sequencing to every frame, then receives the frame acknowledgement from the receiver, then perform the error control and flow control to avoid the data loss or to avoid the frame lost. After that, access control. When the single communication channel is shared by multiple devices, MAC sublayer of data link layer helps to determine which device has control over the channel at a given time. Feedback. After transmitting the frames, the system waits for the feedback. All these are the functions of data link layer. Next layer is a network layer. This is the third layer of the network, and this layer, the data is called the packets because every packet contains the source and destination IP address, which are required to transmit the data from source to destination, plus the data which we want to transmit. The functions of the network layer. Routing. The network layer protocols determines which route is the best for data transmission from source to destination. Then logical addressing. Network layer provides the logical address, that is unique address for every device, that is called IP address, which is added into the every header of the packet. Internetworking. And internetworking is the main responsibility of the network layer. It provides the logical connection. Packetizing. The network layer receives the packet from upper layer and convert them into the packets. This is known as packetizing. Next is a fragmentation, means divide the large packet into the smaller packet so we can easily transmit that packet from source to destination using particular physical medium. Next layer is a transport layer. that is number 4 layer. This transport layer is responsible for packet delivery, and it gives the sequence to every packet with no loss or no duplication. It provides the two types of services. One is connection oriented and another one is connectionless. In connection oriented, there are three phases. One is connection establishment, after that data transfer, and connection termination. In this type of transmission, the receiving device sends the acknowledgement back to the source after the packet of or group of packets is received. This type of transmission is reliable and secure. Connectionless transmission. It is a one-phase process that includes the data transfer. In this type of transmission, the receiver does not acknowledge the receipt of the packet. This approach allows for much faster communication between the devices. Connection-oriented devices is more reliable than connectionless service. Next layer is a transport layers. Next point is a transport layer functions. Sorry guys, just wait for 1 minute. Functions of the transport layer. Service point addressing. The transport layer adds the header that contains the address known as service point address or port address. The responsibility of the network layer is to transmit the data from one computer to another computer. And the transport layer, the responsibility of the transport layer is to transmit the message to the correct process. Segmentation and assembly, that is segmentation is performed at the transport layer and at the receiver side, this using the particular sequence number, reassembly of the packets is also performed. Connection control. Transport layer provide two services, that is connection oriented and connection less service, and with the help of this it performs connection control. Next is flow control and error control to avoid the loss of data or loss of segments or packets. Message acknowledgement. It provides the reliable end-to-end message delivery with acknowledgement. Message traffic control. It tells the transmission station to back off when no message buffers are available. Next layer is a session layer. It is the fifth layer of OSM model for establishment of session, maintenance of session, that is for interaction between the communication system, and then session termination. It allows the two applications running on different computer to establish, use and end a connection called session. It performs the name recognition and security. What are the functions of the session layer? Establishment, maintenance and termination of session that allows the two processes to establish, use and terminate the connection. After that, synchronization. This layer allows the process to add checkpoints which are considered as synchronization point into the data. These synchronization points helps to identify error so that data is resynchronized properly and end of the message are not cut prematurely and data loss is avoided. After that, dialog control. This layer allows two systems to start the communication with half duplex, otherwise full duplex. Session support. It performs the function that allows these processes to communicate over the network, performing security, name recognition, logging, and so on. Next is the presentation layer. It serves as a translator layer of the OSI model and is responsible for data conversion and encryption. This layer may translate data from one format at the sender side station and then translate into the common format. And after that, convert this common format to the format known to the receiving device. The functions of the presentation layer. First is a translation from one format to another format, which is known to the server, sender as well as receiver. After that, it performs the encryption to maintain the privacy or security of data. Okay, encrypt the data at the sender side and it decrypt at the receiver side. Compression. Data compression is the process of compressing the data to reduce the number of bits to be transmitted. It is very important in multimedia such as text, audio and video. The last layer, that is application layer, which is the topmost layer of OSM model, which provides the interface and service that supports user application and provide general access to the network. Application layer serves as window for application to access the network service. Application layer is very useful for file transfer, access and management. Okay, it is used for mail application for sending and receiving mail. It provides the functions like file transfer, mail service, network virtual terminal that allows the user to log on to the remote device, that is virtual communication. Then remote login. This layer allows the login into the host which is remote. Then network abstraction. It provides an abstraction of the underlying network to an end user and application. Okay, this is the functions of all the layers of the OSI model. Thank you guys.